track and field and sprint events. There are three main events for sprinting in track and field. The 100 meter. The 100 meter is the shortest foot race held at the international level. It is one of the most popular and prestigious events in track and field, and the champion of the 100 meter at the Olympics is typically referred to as the fastest man in the world. The 200 meter. The 200 meter is the second shortest foot race held at the international level. Many competitors of the 100 meter often participate in the 200 meter events as well, in hopes of winning both titles. This is called doubling up, or simply the double. The 400 meter. The 400 meter is the longest distance in the category of sprints. Compared to the 100 meter and the 200 meter events, it places a stronger emphasis on endurance rather than pure speed, and this requires a slightly different energy use strategy. The 100 meter start line. All competitors in the 100 meter race begin side by side on the same straight starting line located on the straightaway. The 200 meter and the 400 meter start lines. While the 100 meter sprints use a straight line, the 200 meter and the 400 meter sprints feature a staggered start, in which the start lines in each lane are progressively moved further up, beginning with the lane closest to the field. This is to account for the oval geometry of the track, which causes the diameter of the outer lanes to be greater than the diameter of the inner lanes. And having a staggered start ensures that all competitors in a 200 meter and a 400 meter sprints are running the same distance around the curved oval track. The call. Every sprinting event begins with a call from the starter, instructing all competitors to make their way into their assigned lanes and to assume their positions in front of their starting blocks. And the starting block is located behind the starting line and consists of two adjustable foot plates attached to a rigid frame against which the competitor must brace his feet before the start of the race. How to play track and field for short distance or sprints. Sprinting is a segment of track and field that focuses on a runner covering a distance over a short period of time. Unlike marathon races, sprinting races are short and less than a minute long. In a track and field competition, there are generally three different sprint distances: 100 meter, 200 meter, and 400 meter. The original Olympic event, the Stadion Race, was a sprint of around 180 meters. Although it sounds simple, there are few technicalities to sprinting. A sprint race starts out with the runners in starting blocks in their lane. Starting blocks are foot frames that the runners use to set themselves up prior to the race. Sprinters typically wear their track uniform with a number on it so others are able to identify the players. At the official's command, on your mark, all competitors should be focused on the track, must assume the crouch start position, have their feet placed in the blocks, fingers on the ground behind the starting line, hands slightly wider than shoulder width, and muscles relaxed. Next, the official will say set. All competitors must assume the set position, or the four-point start position. The knee of the rear leg raises to an angle between 120 to 140 degrees, while the knee of the front leg bends to a 90 degrees, their hips slightly above shoulder level, the majority of the body weight must be between the hands and the front legs, feet pushed hard into the blocks, holding their breath and ready to race. Then there is the bang, and the race has started. The runner should exhale and run out of the blocks, not jumping. The initial part of the race, the runner is accelerating to top speed. Every runner is assigned to a specific lane in which he or she must remain in for the entirety of the race. This is defined as staying within the boundaries of the lane lines and applies to all parts of the competitor's body and clothing. Once top speed is achieved, then endurance kicks in as the runner tries to maintain the speed for the rest of the sprint. Sprinters should remain relaxed while running and move their arms in a straight back and forth motion. They should be focused on their lane and the track at the start and the finish line for the last half of the race or so. Not many people are successful at sprinting because of the intensity of the sport. It requires a lot of practice and speed that cannot be acquired easily. Muscle strength is also essential as all of the leg muscles are completely used in every race. Relays. Relay races are where teams of runners compete against each other. There are typically four runners and four legs to the race. The first runner starts with a baton and runs the first leg, handing off to the second runner. The handoff must typically take place within a given area of the track. The second then hands off to the third and the third to the fourth. The fourth runner runs the final or anchor leg to the finish line. Common relay races are the 4x1 meter and the 4x4 meter.